Sphere surprised everyone when it was released on PC. Even though the game market was just as overflooded with first-person shooters as now, Sphere did something special by mixing the visceral FPS adrenaline action with an interactive story, yeah, it uses the Half-Life formula, and extraterrestrial horror. All this was made even cooler with the ability to slow down time to master the perfect kills, like in Max Payne. The violence was fun, especially with the very intelligent AI that had you on the edge of your seat. One of the most special things about this game, though, was the fact that learning about the story behind the game was optional. You see, the way the story is presented is through answering machines. You must explore the areas and find these answering machines to learn more about the story. If you're the type of gamer who doesn't really care about the story of a game, you didn't have to learn it at all. And somehow, learning a story this way brought kind of realism into the gameplay. But of course, Fear is not without its problems. Every time you complete a section, you'll be awarded with a loading screen that lasts at least 30 seconds. This is true for pretty much all versions of the game, because I watched my friend play the PC version and loading times are pretty damn long. On the PS3 version, it's actually longer. I think the PS3 version is the worst port out of, you know, the worst version. The 360 version is a bit better. PC version is, of course, the best version. The levels themselves aren't that spectacular either. You will be stunned during the first few hours of gameplay, but once you reach a certain point, you will come to realize that, really, all the levels kind of look the same. The same narrow halls, the same office cubicles, the same ventilation system, the same cafeterias, the same walls again. The monotony of the environment is beyond repetitive. Even when the game tries to redeem itself by offering you cool weapons and by introducing new type of enemies like sentry drones, gigantic robots armed with rocket launchers, by the last few levels of the game you just want to be done with the game. Except for the second to the last level, the repetitive nature of the game is reinforced by extremely linear design of the levels. The levels are so linear that ultimately, it doesn't matter that the enemy AI is smart. You can beat the game virtually without getting hit. If you hide behind cover and use slow motion wall, since the enemies can rush you on only one spot. So this is what I did pretty much by the half point of the game. What I did was I waited in this one corner, you know, in a narrow hall. I waited in the corner. And then as soon as I saw an enemy just rush at me, slow down time, headshot. Done. And the enemies will keep rushing at you like that because there's only one spot to rush you. They can't flank you in any way because of the linear level design. So doing it that way, it felt cheap and it was really easy. But of course, there's more exciting ways to play the game, like not using bullet time. But that just gives you an example of how linear the level design really is. Especially in combat sections. I mean, there are branching paths. You can, especially for the answering machines. You know, there's branching path to get to the answering machine, find more about the storyline. But as far as the actual set pieces where you fight against enemies, the level design is pretty linear. There's only two instances where I remember it wasn't so linear. There's the part where there's the elevator, right? There is a rectangular narrow halls. There's two elevators that come down. So there's this way for the enemies to flank you, and there's this way. But that part, I really didn't have to worry about flanking, because I went this way. I waited. I made some noise. The enemy guard. This was the quickest way for the enemy to come. So I waited, slowed down time, killed these enemies here. Then I rushed them over here. There's like five enemies over here. Slow down time. Shotgun. 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 So there's that. There's another section on the rooftops where it wasn't as linear, but you get the basic idea. So the enemy AI is actually pretty impressive. They will flank you. They will throw grenades. for this time, it was pretty revolutionary. Now it's 2010. It's not as revolutionary anymore, but I guess back in the day, it was pretty awesome what the enemy AI did. So anyway, that's really what I meant to say about the levels. That is really linear. Another major flaw to this game is the story itself. Presenting the story through answering machine is a great concept. However, it's a concept that really should have stayed on the brainstorming board a little bit longer, because the way it's executed is a million miles away from being satisfactory. I found 70% of all the answering machines in the game, and about 90% of them were irrelevant to the story. The answering machines don't really tell you much about the story at all, and it just feels like random dialogue and constant sprouting of profanity. I mean, don't cuss at you, just ridiculously. Fuck this, fuck that! But it doesn't really tell me much about the story at all. They're so irrelevant that you can actually understand the story of the game without finding a single one. The ending parts of the game reveal everything you need to know about the story anyway. That was disappointing as well. For most of the game, all you're doing is walking, crawling, shooting, and shooting some more. But you learn virtually nothing about the story. Then you reach the last level and wham, everything is revealed to you. It felt sudden and rushed. And let's talk about the last level. What was that? It was the most lame level design I've experienced in a long time. The horror element of the section felt forced and dull. It wasn't scary, and it wasn't exciting, and it was easy as hell. Not to mention, the console versions of this game is so much worse. And let's finally end this video with talking about the console versions. So, the 360 version is pretty much near identical to the PC version graphically, except a bit dumbed down. But the PS3 version is a port of the 360 version, which was a port of the PC version. What does that mean? The PS version utterly sucks. It's riddled with frame rate problems, pop-ins, and even some minor glitches. The lagging of the PS version is so bad that only the most patient of the gamers, graphically speaking, like me, can sit through it. Maybe the PS3 version of the game thinks you're a noob to this game and wants you to use the slow motion ability all the time. Whatever the case, the lag is ridiculous, and the loading times, I don't even want to talk about the loading times. So all in all, the game was a great concept, but the execution is rather poor. The console versions, especially the PS3 version, is dumbed down from the PC version, and the monotonous environments will constantly remind you of the meaning of the word, repetitive.